So good morning everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about the state variable analysis. So here we are going to discuss about what is state variable analysis, what is state and also state vector and state space, okay, and also the relationship between the equation, the linear time invariant state equation of linear time and invariant system we are going to discuss over in this video. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about the state of variables. Okay, so it is the analysis and the design feedback control system by classical design methods based on the transfer function approach are inadequate and not convenient, so the development of state variable approach took place. So this method has the following advantages over the classical approaches. So for this purpose we are going to use this state variable analysis. So here we are going to discuss about, so it is a direct time domain approach. Okay, so this approach is suitable for digital computer for computation, and it is a very powerful technique for design and analysis of linear, non-linear, time variant, time invariant, and SI, SO, or MIM. Here the term SI, SO, and MIMO indicates the simple input, simple output, and MIMO system is the multiple input, multiple output, it will be states. Okay, so in this technique the nth order derivational differential equations can be expressed in the n equations of the first order, thus making solution easier. So using this approach, system can be designed for optimal condition with respect to given performance indices. So normally, so the time domain it will be used for in the computers, and here the powerful technique of design and analysis is the simple input, simple input, simple output, or multiple input, multiple output systems. Then comes into the state. What is state? Okay, so it is the dynamical system is a minimal set of variation x1 of t and x2 of t, x3 of t up to the xn of t, such that the knowledge of these variables at t is equal to t0. So it is usually going to take this initial conditions. So together with the knowledge inputs u1 of t and u2 of t and u3 of t to um of t, so for t greater than or equal to 0 completely determines the behavior of the system for t less than or equal to t0. So this is about the state. Then comes into the state variable. So here also the variables x1 of t, x2 of t, x3 of t, dot xm of t, so such that the knowledge of this variables at t is equal to t0. So this will be a going to take as initial conditions together with knowledge of input u1 of t, u2 of t, u3 of t into um of t for t greater than or equal to t0. So completely determines the behavior system for t less than t0. So these are called state variables. So in other words, the variables that determine the state of dynamical system is called state variables. Okay, so variable can determine the state of determine dynamical system means, that is, we can say it as a state variables. Okay, so this is about the state variable. Comes into the state vector. If a state vector x1 of t, x2 of t, and x3 of t dot dot xn of t are necessary to determine the behavior of the dynamical system, then these n state variables can be considered as a components of vector x of t called state vector. Then comes into the state space. The n dimensional space whose element are then state variables is called state space. So any state can be represented at the point in the state space. So normally, so the n-dimensional space, various element or n state variables is called state space over here. Then comes into the state equation for a linear time or invariant time system. So here u of t and the controlled system controller and y of t and x of t. So it will becomes as a another output. So there are u of t is the one input or x of t and y of t is the two output over here. So here we are going to take x1 of t is equal to f of x1 of t comma x2 of t dot 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 x1 of t into u1 of t u2 of t up to um of t. So same like x2 of t also we are going to take, xn of t also we are going to take like this. F2 of x1 of t into x2 of t comma dot 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 x1 of t up to that. So same like we are going to take. Okay, then here the we are going to integrate in the first equation, then x1 of t is equal to x1 of t naught plus integral of t naught to t limits t naught to t fi upon x1 of tau dot 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 xn of tau semicolon u1 of tau comma u2 of tau up to the um of tau into dt. So here where I is equal to 1, 2, 3 into dot dot n means that the state variable, the state system can be determined at any t less than tn. Okay. So provided each state variable is known as at t is equal to tn. And all the m control forces are known throughout the interval t naught to t. So the n differential equation of one may be written in the vector form x dot of t is equal to f of x of t comma u of t. So this is the second equation. So here where x of t is equal to in the matrix form x1 of t, x2 of t, dot dot dot, x1 of t. So this is the n into 1. So this is state vector u of t. So n of t, u2 of t, dot dot dot, um of t. So input vector. So here m into 1. So the next and f of t. So this will be going to f1 of t and f2 of t, dot dot f1 of t. So this will be going to take n into 1. So this f will be a functional factor vector. So normally x of t is the we are going to take state vector, u of t we are going to take input vector, f of t is the functional vector. So here in the equation 2, state equation for time variant invariant system over net varying the system. So f of t it will be depends on time as well as and the vector equation may be given as x dot of t equal to f of x of t comma u of t comma t. So this is the third equation. This equation is the state equation for time varying equation. So the equation 2 is the time equation for the invariant system. This is the time variant state equation for the time invariant system. Okay, the equation 3 is the state equation for time varying system. So the output y of t can in general be expressed in terms of state vector x of t and the vector u of t as the time invariant system y of t is equal to g into x of t comma u of t. So this is the fourth one for time varying system, y of t equal to g into x of t comma u of t comma t. So this is the last. So this is the equation for time varying system. Okay. So thank you.